早上好，同学们，我是云飞，这里是 Fearless 美洲周报。今天是2021年11月12日，星期五。我们已经完成了第一学期的学习，并迎来了第二学期。成绩单会议将在下周。本次新闻广播是我们在感恩节假期中的最后一次。我们的新闻团队代表多种语言，你可以在 Advisory 中或在 YouTube 频道上观看他们。我们今天的名言是：感恩的心会使你看到更多美好的事物。确保你和你周围的人在校内佩戴好口罩，口罩可以保护你免受新冠病毒的侵害。为了保护你、你的家人和朋友的安全，请戴上口罩。Miss Griffin 和 Miss Ennis 会在下周四早上售卖新鲜的椒盐脆饼，想要购买的同学可以带上$1来学校。双语学生双语小组会议终于来了，它从10月1日的星期一开始。请确保你已经加入在 Google Classroom 的双语班，你可以用你的母语谈论你的需求。如果你有任何问题，可以去215A 问 Miss Notch 或者 email 至。喜欢跑步健身的同学加入 Fearless 跑步俱乐部，去309室找 Miss Chen 了解更多消息。给 Seniors 的通知 ，Seniors 这条消息是来自 Miss Kelsey 的关于大学入学计划的通知。这个项目可以让你参观大学，并获得奖学金。了解高中毕业后的选择，想了解详细消息的同学，每周一和周二都可以在212房间对面的楼梯上找到 Miss Kelsey。 Miss Roddy 的更多消息，普斯坦大学邀请学生于11月20日星期六参观他们的校园，我们将提供一辆巴士从 Girls High 出发。来自费城的 Seniors 可以与监护人一起免费注册2022届的 Google Classroom。 所有 Fearless 的学生，学生政府正在为这个感恩节有需要的人收集不硬腐烂的罐头食品，直到11月23日星期二。本周我们采访了我们的中文老师 Miss Lee。
Good afternoon, I'm He Yan.
I'm Shu Nan.
We are members of Falcon TV News. Today, we are here to talk with Miss Lee, our Chinese language teacher here at Fearless. So, hi, Miss Lee.
Hi. Hello.
Hello.
Hi, Miss Lee. We'd like to know about your teaching experience. So, we are here We'd like to know about your teaching experience. So we are here to get to know you more by interviewing you and asking you some questions.
Sure.
So how many years have you worked at Fearless?
I have been here for 12 years. This is my 13 years at Fearless.
Wow.
Yeah, very long.
Yeah. What's the most difficult part when you are teaching the students?
I think the difficult part is when you have a student, they have a different level of study skill. Some students take a very long time to learn a few words, but some are very fast. So how do you balance these two groups, but they are in the same classroom?
Okay. Yes. In your past experiments of teaching Chinese, when is the time when students impress you?
I still remember there's one student about 7 or 8 years ago. I remember his name. His name is Shaquille. He learned really well. And by the end of Chinese 2, he stand in a group of Chinese students and talking with them. I was really surprised and I feel really, really good when I see that.
Hope next time I can see him.
Okay.
Okay.
How has your teaching changed or immoral over the years?
One thing I noticed is when I first came here, most students who are coming to Chinese class are Native American. They are American. Recently, there's a lot of ESOL students come to learn Chinese. So they have to learn English and Chinese at the same time. The good thing is they are doing very good. They learn Chinese really well.
I saw there are many decorations in your room.
Yes.
Can you tell us about the meaning of them? Like those dresses hanging on the doors?
So the dress I have here are typical Chinese dress for ladies. They are called qi pao, and it's from last dynasty of Chinese history. They start that time. It's about 400 years ago, and it lasts until 70 years ago. So right now, not many people wear them, but occasionally during Chinese holiday, people still wear them.
Oh, they were beautiful.
Thank
yeah.
you. Yeah.
How about those animals?
So those animals, we call them Chinese zodiac animal. That's the way Chinese number the years, name the years. Like in Western culture, you use numbers. In Chinese culture, you use animal. So this year is a year of ox.
Oh, interesting.
Yeah.
How about the words above the blackboard?
What's that? The character I put there, they are Chinese dynasty. The Chinese dynasty started 5,000 years ago. So you can see the first dynasty, Xia dynasty, started 5,000 years ago. So the last dynasty is the Qing dynasty, end at around 100 years ago. Okay, so 5,000 years, Chinese always have different dynasty until the last dynasty. Then we became a republic.
Oh, amazing.
Thank you.
Can you give some advice for students that are currently learning Chinese?
The only advice I want to give is for the students who are learning Chinese, they should practice with a Chinese speaker if they have a chance. And we actually have a good diverse student body here. There's a lot of Chinese students. So if the students who are learning Chinese can speak with Chinese students regularly, it would improve their language skill a lot.
Okay, got you.
Yeah.
Can you teach us one Chinese word?
Sure. In Chinese one, right now we are learning love. In Chinese, love is I. So that's how you say love. So you can say 爱你, 你 means you. So 爱你 means love you.
Okay, love you.
Love you too. 爱你 too.
Okay.
Thank you very much.
Thank you.
You're welcome. You're welcome.
Thank you for teaching Chinese at Fairness. We are grateful that you are here. Have a nice day.
You too. Thank you very much.
Love
for,
you.
Yeah, love you. 爱你.
Okay.
Yeah.
感谢 Miss Lee 抽出宝贵的时间和我们一起，并让我们了解更多有趣的中国文化。对编程感兴趣的同学，可以在每周四放学后去找 Mr. Pasternak 加入机器人俱乐部。需要作业辅导帮助的同学，作业会在星期一到星期四下午2:40。到3:40举行。Furnace 现在有一个 GSA 代表同性恋联盟或性别与自我认知盟。他们每周一 Advisory 在213教室会面。请务必在 Facebook、Twitter、Instagram 上关注我们。并在我们的网站上查看更多有价值的消息。我们的网站还在 YouTube 上以多种语言提供每周公告。本周的公告就到此为止，感谢您的观看。在来学校之前，不要忘了给你的身体 头脑和胸部充电。